You picked up on the words, like you rehearsed it a few times. Of Lakme Fashion Week Summer Resort 2019. This is an extremely unique and one of its kind show that we've had this afternoon. Diamond Producers Association presents The Real Cut. And we have with us here Ms. Richa Singh, Managing Director of Diamond Producers Association, Mr. Jaspreet Chandok, VP and Head of Fashion, IMG Reliance, the beautiful designer Sonal Varma from Rara Avis, Om Jewelers, Bhavna Jhakya, Senko Gold and Diamonds, Rajeshwari Singh, and the beautiful Shibani Dandekar working for them. To begin with, we'd like to hear from you, Ms. Singh, on your collaboration with Lakme Fashion Week for the first time and how it felt seeing all of this come together.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. We are, we are new to the country and we've wanted to tie up with someone who epitomizes fashion, who stands for fashion, and who better than Lakme Fashion Week. We are extremely excited to be here. We think diamonds are a part of every girl's dream and everyday fashion. And, we thought that it's a perfect opportunity for us to show our beautiful designs with the beautiful collections showcased by the designers. We would like to see all of you women wearing diamonds every day, enjoying them and not keeping them in the locker. So hope to see more of it happen on the ramp and in person every day.
Definitely. I think that's something all women are going to take very seriously. Mr. Chandok, if you can talk to us about Lakme Fashion Week's association with the Diamond Producers Association.
No, so when Richa came to us, or we went to her, I'm not quite sure what happened. But once we started talking and deciding what we wanted to do, I think one thing that was very interesting is that she said she wanted to work around everyday wear, everyday jewelry, because the first thing people think about when they want to do Fashion Week is big bridal couture. You know, and that just seemed very interesting to us. She wanted to invest in young designers, young fashion designers, young jewelry designers, you know, and I think that's when you're building something, you know, rather than just doing a show. You know, and I think this is a great first step in our association towards building, you know, and that's what we are most glad of. And I think the collections from all the designers and, you know, even the jewelry with it. In fact, I had a couple of people sitting, you know, right next to me actually discussing the jewelry and saying, you know, this is what we want to pick up. So, you know, I think we've been able to achieve what we went out to do.
It is the perfect marriage when you can find jewelry and clothes at the same time, right? Sonal, we'd love to hear from you on your collection. I think the collection name is, if you help me pronounce it.
It's Resiga.
Resiga, yeah. I was not sure how to pronounce that. So if you can tell us about that.
Okay. So the collection is actually, it resonates with our brand because it's a lot to do with bohemian meets luxury. So it's about this summer resort vacation that I think every woman on planet Earth is planning to take at every point in life. And the clothes were very easy, very effortless. And the whole idea is that it's glamour fused into a camping safari situation. So now things have changed. People really want to plan their outfits when they're traveling. And now everyone's traveling at the drop of the hat. They just need an excuse. So the whole idea of bringing all our techniques and craftsmanship that we've been working with together with this whole idea was very interesting for us. And Shibani turned to be the perfect muse in terms of her vibe, her personality, and it was sort of a very natural extension for us to have her. And as far as the jewelry is concerned, I don't think I could have asked for more. I was very pleasantly surprised that I could use a lot of diamond jewelry with my clothes for day wear, for something that you could use for easy travel as well. So I'm very glad this happened and Lakme gave us this opportunity. And so did the DPA, the Diamond Producers Association. I think this whole amalgamation and everyone put the effort together really worked out for a very novel show. So I'm glad I was a part of it. Thank you.
Bhavna, can we hear from you on Om Jewelers and your association with this?
own jewelers actually enjoys making everyday jewelry, though we have a lot of bridal, but everyday jewelry is the way to go now. The young generation, or should I say the millennials, they love this kind of jewelry which they wear from morning to night. And DPA has really given us this opportunity with Lakme Fashion Week to showcase this. And it's a fantastic platform. So I'd like to thank both of them for giving us this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you. And Rajeshwari.
Yeah. Like they said, these days women won't want big jewelry. They want small, tiny things that they can wear every day. So DPA has taken up lovely platform to show our jewelry. Thank you so much.
And Shibani, we see all these wonderful clothes and jewelry on you. Can you tell us what it felt like walking at Lakme Fashion Week and walking for these wonderful designers and jewelry designers?
Well, I love walking for Lakme. It's always an exhilarating feeling to walk down the ramp, but I think when you're doing it in an outfit that is so intrinsically who you are and what you're about, it's a piece of cake. I think from head to toe, everything that I'm wearing is something that I would wear in my own life. It's not just for today and not just for the runway. I think the outfit is completely effortless, very boho chic kind of vibe. I love the color palette, you know, and the jewelry that's been added to it is something that I kind of do on a daily basis, not necessarily with diamond jewelry, but now that I know that you can do it with diamond jewelry, you know, I think it's a great step forward, because I think when we think jewelry, and especially diamonds and gold, we tend to think heavy sets that you can wear for weddings and other really fancy occasions, and more with traditional wear. But I think that, you know, it's a game changer to know that diamond jewelry is now available in a more minimalistic kind of vibe, and pieced together with an outfit like this. As Sonal said, I don't think that she would have ever even imagined that this kind of collaboration could happen, but, you know, this is the way forward in terms of fashion. So it was really enjoyable. I'm very happy with the outfit, and I'm leaving with it on. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I think that's something that everyone here would love to hear. So thank you all very much.
Thank you.
And we wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Featuring designers Saksha Gupta and Kinnari Kamath.
No, that's not her name.
Yep. Aura.
She's Sasha Bhatt.
Okay. Saksha and Kinnari.
Yes.
Rupam Singhal from Aura. A.S. Motiwala, represented by Shazia Motiwala. And our beautiful showstopper, Pooja Hegde. And we have with us here Richa Singh, Managing Director from the Diamond Producers Association, and Mr. Jaspreet Chandok from IMG Reliance. We'd love to hear from you designers on your thoughts behind this collection.
You can just talk.
Hi. So basically, first of all, we wanted to thank
Lakme Fashion Week and Diamond Producers Association. I think it's just been an incredible initiative, and obviously the platform that they've given to young jewelry designers called The Real Cut. And yeah, I think it was a very interesting collaboration, as you know, you don't normally see fine jewelry, especially such gorgeous jewelry from, you know, AS Motivala, from Aura. You know, you don't tend to hear about fine diamond jewelry paired with resort wear, easy pret wear. So I think it's been so refreshing to even start collaborating on such a cool kind of initiative. So for Kini and I, you know, we're known for layering, layers upon layers. So we had to kind of a little bit hold back this season. And, you know, we really wanted the diamonds to also be showcased and, you know, visible. So we kept in mind, obviously, the jewelry, and our collection is all about North India, South India. We've taken inspiration from the lungi, the traditional Tamil Nadu lungi, and paired it with ikats from Gujarat, Leheria from Rajasthan. And it's really a marriage between two cultures, no borders. And I think even with the inclusivity of the diamonds, it's, you know, that reinforcing that, you know, there's no such thing as only fine jewelry can be paired with gowns and bridal wear. It's a really cool initiative that lets bring our diamonds into the forefront in day-to-day resort wear too. So it's been really interesting.
Kini, if we can hear from you too.
As Saksha said, the same thing, that it's really nice and refreshing to see colorful clothes being paired with fine jewelry.
Excellent. And if we'd love to hear from the jewelry designers as well. Shazia?
Yeah. Hi. First of all, I would like to thank Diamond Producers Association and Lakme Fashion Week. We're just extremely flattered to be a part of this initiative. And Lakme Fashion Week has always been a celebration of the country's finest talent. So yeah, it's overwhelming to be here. And coming to the our line, so Faith was born out of an idea that every woman should own a piece of fine jewelry. And so keeping that in mind, we re-engineered our designs to make it very lightweight, very wearable, you know, basically like from a breakfast to brunch kind of a jewelry. You really don't have to try very hard that it should fit or fit into with, you know, with some look or the other. It should be like with every look, like from the morning to the evening, with whatever your agenda is. So incorporating it basically in your daily lifestyle. And this line, the inspiration that we've got is, we've drawn is from positivity and the elements of nature. So as you see, Pooja is wearing a beautiful pair of earrings, which, you know, to get to get the colors of nature, we've used enamel. So yeah, that's how we've captured it. And and Saksha and Kini, your stuff goes, you know, the resort wear is so flowy, and it just complements the jewelry, and the jewelry, I think, complements their lovely creation. So really happy to be a part of this. Thank you very much, guys.
I would like to thank DPA, Diamond Producers Association, Richa, and Lakme for, you know, giving us this lovely platform, The Real Cut, to showcase our collections. It's an honor to be here. It's really exciting. Talking about the collection which we have developed, so while designing this line, we studied what kind of collection Saksha and Kini are working on. They have created lovely prints and very beautifully fused different colors, which, you know, very bold colors with very subtle colors. So, you know, we studied what necklines they are working on. The pieces which we have created are very light, functional, fun, airy, and you'll see a lot of chains being used in the designs. The idea was chain as an element is always taken a backstage in jewelry designing. So we thought, why not to bring it in the forefront and use that with, you know, with diamonds. So diamonds and chains together come to create style and statement pieces. So that was so less is more is something which we have been following on for the daily wear collection. That is the mantra behind this line. Thank you.
And Pooja, you look ready to walk off the runway into a brunch somewhere. So how do you feel walking for this association?
Oh,
I do feel very young, fresh, and I just love the outfit. I think I'm going to be wearing a lot more of Saksha and Kini. They're very talented designers, and I think that's what's great about Lakme is that it's such a great platform. They were Gen X designers. And they're here today, which it's really credible. I have to say that when I saw their work, I was genuinely excited to be working for them. And thank you to the Diamonds Producers Association for giving me this opportunity. And I think with Aura and AS Motiwala Fine Jewelry, they've really nailed it because I think that the culture of wearing jewelry for your day-to-day life is something that... it was really required because I think we've just been wearing chunky jewelry for weddings and we need to change that concept because I think the younger generation is just preferring more fine stuff. So it's great and just it's all-inclusive is the theme this year and they've really nailed it with the entire lungi, the South Indian, the Gujarati, the Rajasthani prints. So fab show, each and every garment was really pretty and kudos to you all.
Thank you all so much and we wish you all the best. And with jewelry designers Kirti Lals, Raghu and Seema, Chiripal Jewelers Akshita Garg and the beautiful Urvashi Rautela working for them. And we have with us Richa Singh, Managing Director from the Diamond Producers Association and Mr. Chandok from IMG Reliance. We'd love to begin by hearing from you, Anjali, on your collection and the thoughts behind it.
Hi, I'm Anjali. So most of my collections are story-based. They're quite print-heavy and they can be sometimes overly vivid. So I have no particular reason for having picked Jahanara, but for a book that I read called The Shadow Princess by an author called Indu Sundaresan. Personally, I'm a big fan of Mughal history, and I read a lot, but this book was a wonderful novel telling the story of Jahanara Begum, who was the eldest of Shah Jahan's children. Her mother, Mumtaz Mahal, whom we very well know, was the reason that the Taj Mahal was built in her memory. And such a magnificent monument, I didn't quite realize the magnitude of Jahanara's role in the whole thing until I came across Indu's book. And I contacted Indu a few months ago in the US and I told her, look, I love this story and I want to design something around it. And she said, what are you going to do? It's a book. So I said, look, maybe we can tell the story of the mood of Jahanara's life as she held the empire together. She didn't get married. She fell in love. She had a child, abandoned that child, and really, quite frankly, held that empire together until the unfortunate coup that Aurangzeb orchestrated. And that was the end of that era. And I was so taken by it, I had to actually get permission from HarperCollins to use the name. And I've been back and forth with Indu. I really wish she was there for the show. But I wanted to just humbly portray just the mood of that princess and her storyline through the prints and the vibe. And I enjoy designing resort wear, so it's been fun. But I hope I've done a little bit of justice to Indu's book. And I also wanted to specially mention thank you to IMG and the Diamond Producers Association for this fantastic opportunity that we've all had to pair our clothes and designs with such fine young contemporary jewelry. And thanks, Urvashi, for walking. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Mr. Raghu, yeah, Vanakkam.
Yes. Vanakkam.
Welcome to Lakme Fashion Week Summer Thank Resort you. 2019. In the Lakme Fashion Week, la ungaloda collection paatha ungalku eppadi feeling varudhu ungalku ramp mele ungaloda beautiful jewelry paatha ungalku eppadi feeling varudhu
adhaavadhu paathaaka ellarume over jewelry wear pannumbodhum avangalukulla kannadi mari inna oru smile pannipaanga ellarume andha smile dhaan enoda main inspire so adhu vandha enoda design layum kondu varanumgiradha enoda mudhal thought ave irundhuchu enakku
so he said you speak tamil as well right
hangen alva hangen elbow resko sudaro to dagdide அதோட எஸ்டிமேஷன் அஷ்டே.
So his translation for the non-Tamilians in the room was, when someone looks at themselves wearing beautiful jewelry and smiles, that's his inspiration for his collection, and he wants to create every piece that resonates that. So when every woman wears any jewelry that they have created, he wants them to feel that joy, that beauty, and that pride for themselves. And that was his inspiration for his collection. Yeah?
That was pretty good.
Thank you. வேற ஏதாவது சார் சொல்கிறீங்களா?
அதாவது இந்த உலகத்தில் பார்த்தாக்கா ரொம்ப அதிகமான இன்ஸ்பயர் நிறையா இருக்குது, ரொம்ப குட்டி கிடக்குன்னு சொல்லலாம். அதுவும் மோஸ்ட் ஆஃப் தமிழ்நாட்டில் அதிகமாகவே இருக்குது சொல்ல போனாக்கா. ஒவ்வொரு நாங்கள் பண்ணக்கூடிய ஒவ்வொரு டிசைன்ஸுமே நேச்சர்லேருந்து கலெக்ட் பண்ணி அதுலேருந்து டைமண்டை ப்ரொஜெக்ட் பண்ணக்கூடிய அளவுக்கு எந்தெந்த டிசைன்ஸ் இருக்கோ அதை வந்து கன்வெர்ட் பண்ணி நாங்கள் ஜுவல்லரி வந்து மேக் பண்ணிருக்கோம்.
So he says there's so much inspiration in the world for beauty, but he feels like Tamil Nadu has some of the largest inspiration for nature, and that's where he draws his inspiration for the jewelry collection. And he's looked at nature that's existing in Tamil Nadu and he's used them to depict his collection. Correct? Okay.
Yes.
Romba Nandri.
We're very lucky to have you.
Can we hear from you too?
Sure.
Seema.
Namaskar and good afternoon to everyone. It's really very exciting to be a part of this incredible collaboration and very, very unique collaboration as well. At Kirtilal's, it's our 80th year this year, so it's quite an iconic moment where we can stop for a minute and celebrate our 80 decades in jewelry that we're really proud about. We've had 4 generations with us, and I think at this turning point, this makes a lot of sense because jewelry really is taking on completely new facets in our country, I think, all over the country. And I think it's expanded just people's minds on how they think about jewelry, and not, you know, where they don't just think of jewelry as something they purchase before they get married, but it's become something that the woman wants to spend her first salary on a piece. And it's a matter of great pride that she can do it with her own earned money. So it's very exciting to be a brand that is primarily focusing on women, of course, and that we're able to, you know, bring out that independence and that pride in women. And so with fashion and jewelry, obviously, it's all just very complimentary. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And Akshita, we can hear from you too.
Hello, I'd like to thank Diamond Producers Association and Lakme Fashion Week for giving us this opportunity. Our brand, Akshita Garg Chirapal Jewelers, is very lucky to have a very contemporary clientele, and we are having more clients who want to wear stuff every day. And so it's something which really goes along with our brand in a sense that, so for me, I started wearing diamonds when I was 16, and being that young, finding something to wear every day was really the inspiration which started this all. And again, whenever girls like our age earlier would want to save up money and buy something, I think diamonds is one thing where you can apologetically splurge on. It's going to be there with you forever, and you can really style it with literally anything. I mean, look at the gorgeous hoops Urvashi is wearing, and it's something which you can wear with resort wear, with something like what I'm wearing, and it's something, again, which is a good investment also. So, yeah, thank you.
And Urvashi, on the beautiful jewelry and clothes you're wearing and walking at Lakme Fashion Week, how was the feeling?
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon to all the members of media. I'm extremely grateful to Lakme Fashion Week. Insta glad you came, my Maddie, and my beautiful designer, Anjali. Veranda is the brand's name. I have to add this one special mention that right since childhood, I was always very fascinated with the Mughal Empire, with the Mughal culture, with the Taj Mahal. And in fact, last year, I had a visit to Taj Mahal as well. So I've always been very fascinated and attracted towards that culture. I never thought that I'll get to wear something like, you know, a collection which is beautifully designed by designer Anjali, and it's designed. The collection theme is the Princess Jahanara, the Shadow Princess. It's very, very comfortable, and I think all of my fans or everyone, I mean, it's definitely going to be a very new look for them. I'm wearing something like this for the very first time. So yeah, I mean, I'm extremely grateful to Veranda and the jewelry designer, Akshita. She's done a fabulous job with all her regal designs. Very beautiful, young and talented. And then, yeah, Lakme Fashion Week as well. The beautiful association with the Jewelry Producers Association and the Lakme Fashion Week. I think this is something which is going to be constantly inspiring us and for the future as well. So I'm extremely grateful and thank you everyone. Thank you, Veranda. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We all hope all your collections walk off the ramp and into someone's wardrobes very soon. Thank you.
Dada.
क्या करोगे खा जाओगे